So, who are you following? If you think about it, from childhood, many of us learn very early how to follow. We follow instructions, rules, older adults. We even play games, like follow the leader. Learning how to follow is something that we just pick up on when we enter into the world. The question, though, is when do we learn how to lead? Keep watching to find out.
It's hard in today's society figuring out who and what to follow. At some point, you find that you're following something, whether it's trending on the block or trending on social media. The truth is, we all follow something at some time in our life. But what you have to think about is who and what you're really following. Not everything is good to follow, and just because something is trending doesn't mean it's the right thing to do.
Finding out what's good for you can be difficult, especially when social media and society call your attention to everything and everyone else. With so many distractions, it can be tough learning how to lead. As you're figuring out what works for you and what's worth your time and energy, check out some of the things that helped us along the way. Number one, think about why you're following. Sometimes growing up, it's easy to follow other people because they intimidate you or make you feel afraid. I remember seeing it myself in school. It was easier for some students to follow others and become their friend, rather than stand up and say, no, what you're doing is wrong. If you find that you're following someone because you're afraid of them, or maybe it's hard for you to stand up to them and say how you feel, talk to an adult you can trust. Somebody in your family, your counselor at school, or even a friend's parent you feel comfortable with. Whoever you decide, be sure to let an adult know.
Another reason people follow is so they can become popular or get noticed, from changing what they wear, how they act, or even their friends. It can become tempting to follow so that you can fit in, and wanting to fit in is normal, but you have to remember that the most important thing in fitting in is being true to who you are. Tip number two, think about what you're following and if it makes sense. If there's a challenge going on in your school or in your neighborhood and it sounds a little off, it is. Trust your gut. Don't follow or agree to something that does not sound right or make sense to you. Be sure to listen to yourself. I remember growing up, I made a bad decision. I had allowed somebody else to convince me to steal a car along with some of my friends. We did everything that we was not supposed to do. And the worst thing about the situation is that I knew better. I knew that I should not have made the decision that I made. I'm just thankful that the situation didn't turn out worse. And I realized after that happened that I really needed to think about who I surrounded myself with.
Number three, figure out what matters to you and not what everyone around you wants. Many times we follow other people because we don't know what we want or what we like. Take some time to think about what's interesting to you. If you're on Pinterest and you love do-it-yourself videos, watch them. Just because your friends and family can't stand the thought of crafting doesn't mean you can't love it. When you figure out what matters to you, not only do you stay true to yourself, but you increase your opportunities to lead somebody else.
Tip number four, think about what example that you want to set for others. We all, whether you know it or not, have people watching us, waiting to see what type of example we will set. When we talk about being a leader, we have to remember what we want people to see in us. What type of traits can you use to set a positive example? Maybe you're a go-getter, a trendsetter. How can you use these traits to set a good example? Well, if you notice that people are paying attention to the trends you set, maybe you can focus on trending something positive from the way you talk to people, the way you treat them. Maybe instead of walking past the kid in the hallway that nobody sees, nobody talks to, nobody even knows exists, start a conversation, give them a compliment, find out who they are. These are the things that people will see and are definitely worth following.
Number five, when you're thinking about what and who you're following and figuring out ways that you can lead, it is so important to hang around people who are thinking like you. If you're motivated to do something positive, hang with other people who are motivated to do the same thing. If you're coming up on 18 and you're trying to focus on your future, guess what? You need to be around other people who are thinking the same way. If not, it's very easy to get distracted and even put your plans to the side because you're so focused on what those around you are doing, which doesn't seem to really line up with what you want. And when this happens, it makes it really easy to get off track.
Remember, at some point in life, we all follow something, but not everything is worth following. And just because something is trending doesn't mean it's the right thing to do. Be careful when choosing who and what to follow.
Until next time, remember, you have the power to think, create, and change your own situation. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, and share. And be sure to check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. Hey, no.